Okey, assalamualaikum. Kita akan sambung business plan chapter 5 untuk subjek entrepreneurship part 2. Okey, dalam part 2 ni kita akan discuss content-content yang point-point yang perlu ada di dalam business plan. First, kita ada executive summary, second, introduction and purpose, third, business and owner background, and then organizational, marketing, financial and operation plan. Pun saya dah sentuh dalam part 1, and then project implementation, then the final subtopic is conclusion. Okay, kita tengok apa yang perlu ada dekat executive summary. Pentingnya pada video ni, part 2 ni adalah kita ada satu assessment business plan. Untuk assessment business plan dalam subjek entrepreneurship ni adalah markahnya 30%. Jadi saya nak semua ambil perhatian. Keyword-keywordnya dah ada dalam video ni. Saya dah huraikan sedikit lah yang ada di dalam chapter ni. Okay, kita tengok apa yang perlu ada adalah first, executive summary. Executive summary highlight the most important point of your business plan. Second, identify the company, background, structure and location. Executive summary ni dalam one page lah. One until two page. One page, kita describe, kita summarize apa company kita buat, most important kita punya main product yang kita ada. Identify the company, background, structure, location, describe what the company does, that the market survey. And then point number 4, describe the market potential for the company, product and service. Market trend, apa the market analysis yang kita dah buat. Introduction and purpose, introduction, view and evaluate the purpose of business venture in objective and critical particular manner. Dalam introduction tu cerita company background in details, lagi apa lagi. And then the purpose is to analyze and evaluate the viability of the proposed venture, convince relevant parties of the investment potential in the project, lagi apa lagi, provide guidance in managing business, allocate business resource effectively. So dalam introduction and purpose ni kita, we are using a positive word, make it simple, so let the other people easy to understand. And then the most of it kita kena cerita kita punya core business, core strength yang ada di dekat company kita lah. For business background section, this section of your business plan generally consists of 2 or 4 sections that present information that is specifically for your business. Business background should be kita cerita kita punya history of the company, product achievement, lagi kalau kita ada product certificate. For example, ISO ke, SIRIM ke, international standard ke, ataupun win mana-mana innovation punya competition. So, masukkan di dalam business background. Lagi kita ada owner background. Owner background ni pun penting juga. Jadi, dekat owner background ni biasanya, contohnya investor, dia akan tengok adakah owner tu ada background in managing, background in certain-certain related to the company. Dia achievement. Dia highest education ke. Jadi owner background pun penting juga untuk tarik customer ataupun investor ke dalam company. So businesses are only as credible as their people managing them. So mestilah seiring dan sejalan lah. Betulah company itu hebat, mestilah kita punya leader kita pun mesti hebat juga lah. Okay, next, planning. Okay, dalam planning ni saya pecahkan kepada 4 lah. Tadi dalam video 1 pun saya dah sebut. Dalam organizational planning, kita ada policy and procedure. Jadi cuba carilah apa policy and procedure and rule yang berkaitan dengan business kita. Strategic, tactical maksudnya kita reshuffle resources yang kita ada. Strategic in term of carta organisasi lah. Carta organisasi macam mana kita susun kita punya resources. Contingency plan in case what we are planning tu not happen. So contingency plan ada tak? So the next is R&D, research and development. Kita kena ada satu team untuk menggerakkan company kita ke arah ke depan lah, dengan ada research and development. And then point marketing, kita kena tahu kita punya strength of the product yang kita ada. Pricing, price, adakah price kita tu murah ke mahal ke, bila kita nak bagi discount, bila kita nak bagi promotion. Advertising, tool apa yang kita guna advertising, mungkin Facebook ad ataupun kita gunakan conventional punya method, melalui newspaper ke, melalui magazine, melalui TV atau radio. Say forecast maksudnya prediction. Forecast ni adalah kita punya prediction marketing. Contohnya bila kita buat sale macam ni, apa kita punya expect in return? In return sale kita akan bertambah sebanyak 20%, 30%. Lagi potential or existing customer. Potential customer, existing customer. Macam mana kita nak approach? Kalau existing customer, macam mana kita nak approach? Dalam konteks service center, contohnya ada model baru, contohnya Honda lah yang saya pasal lah. Sekiranya ada model kereta yang baru dikeluarkan oleh Honda, biasanya service center akan hantar invitation card kepada existing customer yang mana yang telah membeli kereta Honda pada sebelum-sebelum ni lah. Dia hantar invitation card untuk owner tu, existing customer tu, untuk datang dan beri priority kepada mereka untuk mencuba kereta baru, test drive lah. Test drive kereta baru lah. Yang saya pasang Honda je buat macam tu. Kalau yang lain saya tak pastilah. Potential customer, get their contact, contact number and follow up. Follow up, asking them, offer them, promotion, inform them when we have a discount program ke anything special lah. Financial, kita ada cash flow, return of investment. Kita dalam planning tu cash flow, of course lah, kita dah bincang pada sebelum ni cash flow. Cash flow maksudnya kita ada amount of money, contohnya 500,000 kita nak channel kepada inventory, nak channel kepada R&D, nak channel kepada marketing, salary dan hire new staff dan sebagainya. Jadi dalam cash flow kita tu, macam mana kita nak manage? Okay, return of investment, setiap kali apa yang kita invest tu, kita nak tahu bila kita punya ROI. 1 year ke, 2 year ke, 3 year ke, lagi cepat lagi bagus lah. Bila return of investment tu, contoh 1 year, target 3 year kan, tapi 1 year tu kita dah achieve kita punya apa, ROI. So second year profit lah, third year profit, fourth year. And then asset, buying asset or renting asset, asset and liability. Asset yang mana kita gunakan untuk jana pendapatan. Liability ni kita perlukan liability ni. Contohnya dekat kita punya store tu, kita nak pasang icon ke. Liability, perlu tak icon? Perlulah, sebab memberi keselesaan kepada customer. Jadi bukan customer datang nak beli account kan, tapi dia nak beli benda lain, nak beli produk kita tu dengan lebih selesa. Liability, renovation, apa lagi, computer, kereta, company. Okay, untuk operational, kita ada facilities. Facilities ni boleh masuk office, boleh masuk warehouse, boleh masuk kita punya branches. Tu facility, nak bayar sewa lagi, operational lah. Kerana kita nak allocate in term of logistic, in term of distribution. Lagi staffing, kita nak cari pekerja. Lagi quality control, of course lah, kita kena control lah our quality. Sebab sekiranya quality tu below then kita current punya quality, so it will be bad reputation to our branding. Then point number 4, budget and expenses yang diberikan, macam mana kita nak gunakan budget lah, untuk operational. Budget untuk operational termasuklah buying a new equipment ke, expensive maintenance and dan sebagainya lah dalam operational. So project implementation, an implementation plan for a project refer to a detailed description of action that demonstrate how to implement an activity within the project that context of achieving project objective. Project implementation ni maksudnya bila kita dah ada planning tadi, maksudnya ada 4 segment dalam planning. So bila kita dah boleh laksanakan lah implementation ni, bila kita nak laksanakan. For the conclusion, reiterate the opportunity, highlight the key strength of your planning. Jadi summarize your vision, remind the reader why your business is in the position to the successful execute the plan. So dalam conclusion ni, we give hope to our reader, we are going to be a successful company. So keep reminding the reader, supaya reader tu confident dengan kita punya business plan lah. Okay, next quick assessment 5.4. short video, another short video, 1 minute short video, use your handphone lah untuk recording. Instruction as a manager, explain your understanding based on point in organizing marketing, financial and operational plan. Tadi ada keyword-keyword yang saya masukkan di dalam setiap dalam planning tu. Jadi awak pilih lah few points, so explain based on your understanding, apa yang awak faham. In 1 minute video, then upload to the Google Classroom. Don't forget title, QA 5.4, your full name and your registration number. Okay, itu sajalah saya rasa untuk topik ini. Sekiranya ada apa-apa soalan dan juga pandangan, boleh tulis dekat Google Classroom atau WhatsApp atau email saya, dan saya akan respon. Dan untuk topik ni, anda perlu buat business plan, cuba draft dulu business plan, dan saya akan semak lah dari masa ke semasa. Persen markahnya sangat besar, 30%, jadi saya harap semua akan buat lah. Okay, dengan kumpulan masing-masing. Okay, itu saja. Assalamualaikum.